play if you want to beat this team in San Jose, who brings a lot of offensive ability. They skate well. You got to be able to play in their end if you want to beat them. And the way you do that is you forecheck, you generate turnovers, and you create your offense off of those turnovers. And we've been talking about that, McGraw. And that's exactly what happened the other night, a 6-3 victory.
It's almost like, I don't want to say it was a do-or-die game Saturday night, but they certainly didn't want to go down 3-1.
Absolutely not. No, you're 100% right. And I think tonight, you know, I don't want to call it a must-win, and I kind of threw this at Ken Hitchcock yesterday. And, you know, I don't believe in must-wins if your back truly isn't against the wall. This is not a clinching scenario for either team here tonight. But to go back to San Jose down 3-2 obviously wouldn't be ideal. But the Blues need to start protecting home ice. They earned home ice advantage entering this series. They had a great regular season. You got to start playing better at home and winning some of these home games and not make life so difficult. I know the Blues feel like they can win on the road. Both teams feel like they can win on the road, and the Blues are certainly confident away from home ice. But there's something to be said about home ice advantage, and the Blues need to find their game on home ice tonight.
What do we know about Backes and some of the other injuries?
Well, we don't know much. I mean, Backes looked like with about 5 minutes to go in the first period, maybe a little bit more than 5 minutes, got tangled up with Joe Pavelski and went down. Looked rather harmless, but if that was the play in which he got injured, you know, he didn't see any action from that point on moving forward. Didn't play a single shift in the final two periods. And, you know, some of that may have had to do with the fact that the score was a little bit out of hand. That the Blues looked like they had, you know, they were cruising towards a victory. But it looks like he's going to play tonight. Robbie Fabry's another guy who obviously is so important to this hockey club in terms of what he brings offensively. Nobody moves the puck quicker than Robbie Fabry off the rush or even on the power play. You look at some of the plays that he makes on some of these set plays that they have, and we saw that on Troy Brower's victory the other day, his power play goal the other day. But, you know, you saw Robbie Fabry took a massive hit, just a vicious hit from Tommy Wingles right along the boards there, and it didn't look like the puck was anywhere near the hit. I mean, I can't believe there wasn't a penalty called in this specific play. It looked extremely dangerous. I don't think Fabry was expecting the hit. He did return and play for a few shifts after that. But then they sat him down. But it sounds like both guys should be able to go tonight.
All right, let's talk about Troy Brower for a second, because the Blues went out and got him, I guess, for experience. He had been there. He had done that. They traded away a big part of their youth for him. I think, where would the Blues be without Troy Brower in this run?
Well, it's a great question, because you look at his heroics, scoring the game-winning goal in Game 7 against Chicago, 3 points in Game 7 against the Dallas Stars, and he had a terrific series against the Stars. You know, he's been a little snake-bitten here in this series. He hit the post a couple of times in Game 2, I believe, and you saw some frustration for him in Game 2. Then he followed that up with some frustration in Game 3. He took some bad penalties in Game 2. You see him slashing his stick on the bench, slashing his stick on the boards, and I'm not a big fan of that, to be honest with you. I think you got to have some composure. I don't like to see frustration get the most of players, especially, you know, an experienced guy like Troy Brower. And to be honest with you, I was a little surprised to see him, you know, have a few of these outbursts. But then to see him rebound and respond with a performance like he showed the other night kind of gives you an idea of who he is from a character standpoint and who he is from a professional standpoint. Nobody carries themselves in that room with more professionalism than Troy Brower in terms of how he handles himself with the media and his teammates. That was a real positive to see, and he's been a real, real positive addition to the Blues, I think more so than people even thought.
Yeah. All right, Eddie Strickland, Hockey Sense tomorrow night?
Hockey Sense, not till Thursday. We're going to wait till Thursday this week and see if we're preparing for a Game 7 or if we're talking about the Blues advancing to the Stanley Cup Finals. We'll talk about that on Thursday night at 7 o'clock.
Ladies and gentlemen, Andy Strickland, Fox Sports Midwest. They're going to have some post-game coverage, I'm assuming, tonight?
We'll have some post-game coverage tonight on Fox Sports Midwest. So immediately following the game, switch over to Fox Sports Midwest, and we'll have all the post-game coverage you'll look for from following Game 5 tonight.
And do we have a new Strickland in the world?
We've got a new Strickland. As you call it, a new human. Absolutely. Although the new human has not joined us here in the house yet, as my wife and the baby are still in the hospital. They'll come home tomorrow, so we're looking forward to that.
Do we have a name?
A new baby boy, Ty Andrew, was born Friday morning at 8:44, 8 pounds, 4 ounces, and we couldn't be more excited. Really, really excited.
Wow.
And we didn't know what we were having. And this is truly, McGraw, one of the I don't know how to explain it. Obviously, people who have been through this before certainly understand what I'm talking about, but there are very few surprises of this nature that you'll have in life in terms of having a baby and not knowing if it's going to be a boy or a girl. And we already had two girls in the family, so you can only imagine what we were hoping for. And to see a boy pop out of my wife was...
You were hoping for 10 fingers and 10 toes. That's all you cared about.
Well, absolutely. We got that, and we got a healthy little boy.
Yeah. Your own hat trick.
So Ty, is Ty short for anything?
It's not short. It's just Ty. So, I mean, you may have heard of people named Ty in the past, but it's not Tyler. It's not Tyson. It's Ty.
T-I-E? Ty?
T-Y.
I believe there was a golfer in Caddyshack named Ty, wasn't there? Named after the Chevy Chase character in Caddyshack.
Hey, there's been a couple of blues players named Ty as well, although we didn't name them after Ty Conklin or Ty Ratty. So
Ty Strickland is a great hockey name. Ty Strickland. All right. Andy, congratulations to you and yours. Be good, and we'll talk to you tomorrow after the game.
All right. Thanks, McGraw. Take care.
Andy Strickland. There you go. A newest Strickland in the family.